Hi everyone. So Zane is at preschool. Both the two daycare girls I have are sleeping, and Brielle's sleeping on me, so I figured it'd be a good time to make a video. Today I'm going to talk about our daily schedule with a 8-month-old and a 3-year-old and daycare. So on a typical Monday through Friday week, I have daycare kids that come. Excuse me. And daycare kids usually start arriving around 6:45. So Rick gets up for work at 4:30. And because he has to leave the house at 5:30. He takes a crazy long time for a guy to get ready and out the door. Anyway, so he gets up at 4:30 and then he wakes me up around 5:15 because I make his lunch. And then that's usually the time of the day where I go through the house and clean. That's my cleaning time, is at like 5:15 in the morning. And sometimes Brielle wakes up to eat around then, but usually she falls asleep. Very rarely is she up, like stay up. And when she does, it's like, oh, I'm not getting any cleaning done. So usually I spend a good hour cleaning and then I quick shower and get myself ready for the day. And then my kids usually start waking up around the time that daycare kids are arriving. So it's like between 6:45 and 7:30. So once everybody's here, my kids are kind of up, we have breakfast, and then we just kind of usually play in the morning, kind of just free play, and I play with the kids, we turn on music, we play instruments, we play with whatever toys I have out for the week. This week happens to be the Legos and cars. In our living room, I've really been trying to keep minimal toys in here, so I just take out a couple things of toys during the daycare week, otherwise we pretty much play in the playroom. So, yeah, we just play in the morning, and then about 9:15 we go wash hands and have a snack. And for morning snack, I always have fruit and milk. So, today we had apple slices and milk. And then usually after that is when in the summer we usually have outdoor play, and it's fall, so it kind of varies whatever the weather is. But if it's a nice day, that's when we go outside and play, is after snack time. We usually play until I have to come in and make lunch at around 11, 11:15. More so 11, I guess. And then, but if it's not a nice day and we are going to go outside and play, usually right after morning snack we do some sort of activity. And then after that activity, while I'm making lunch, whatever, the kids just play again, just kind of free play, and I play with them and stuff. And then at 11:30 is when we eat lunch. We try and head in the bathroom at 11:30 to wash hands. It's as approximate as I can. I just, especially now that Zane has preschool, I try and make it right at 11:30 because he usually leaves for the bus around 12:10, 12:15. So, yeah, if it's a preschool day, a Monday for Wednesday for him, he gets on the bus, yeah, 12:10, 12:15-ish. And lately it's been nice, so I actually take all the kids out in the front yard after lunch, and we just kind of play it in the front yard until Zane gets on the bus. And then, or if it's not a preschool day, usually we just play inside. And then around 12:40, I'd say, we start cleaning up. I try and get all the toys and the kitchen cleaned up before nap time. So I try and get all the kids to help, and they do okay. They do okay. And then, right as soon as all the toys are cleaned up, then we have story time. I pick 3 or 4 books to read to the kids, or sometimes less if kids are throwing tantrums, sometimes more if they're being really good and really liking story time. So we just kind of play it by ear. And then right after that, usually between 1 and 1:15 is when I lay all the kids down for a nap. Brielle, I can't just lay down for a nap. She has to go to sleep when she's tired, and she usually has to fall asleep on me or while nursing. I don't know yet how I'm going to get rid of that, but hopefully it won't last forever. And then, so it varies. A lot of times she'll be ready for a nap around 1 or 1:30, but it does vary. And Zane doesn't nap anymore, so usually I'm not a TV person. I don't like to do TV. So I usually let him watch a show for like 20 minutes or something so I can finish cleaning up the kitchen or get her asleep or something. And then if he doesn't have preschool, he's here. So I have to try and figure out something for him to do for almost 2 hours, which is kind of a long time. So he loves to color, we do Play-Doh, we do lacing beads, board games I do with him. He loves Memory Match. He likes to do brain game books I've showed. But a lot of it is like stuff I have to sit and do with him. So it's like during nap time, if he's here, I have to sit and entertain him the whole time, which isn't always what I want to be doing. It's like when I want my time, I want to get something done. So it's kind of a bummer that he doesn't nap anymore. But, or on occasion he does nap. Like when I first run cartoons for him for about the 20 minutes that we do, sometimes he will fall asleep, but not very often. So anyway, my new plan is I've been working on these busy bags, and I'll be talking more about these later, but that's actually what I'm working on right now. I'm cutting out ice cream cones out of felt. You'll see about that later. So that's what I was working on today. She just had woken up and fell asleep back on me. So yeah, I'm working on some busy bags to try and give him something to do during nap time that won't make me have to be like entertaining him, keeping him quiet at every second during nap time, because that seems to be what it is. Usually around 2:30, 3 o'clock, sometimes even 3:30 is when the kids start waking up from naps. Again, Brielle could wake up at any time. She doesn't really have a schedule at all. I hope she does soon. So then usually around 3:15 we have an afternoon snack, and we usually have juice with our afternoon snack, and then usually some sort of grain-based snack. So sometimes we have crackers or like banana bread. On rare occasion, I'll make cookies, muffins, that sort of thing in the afternoon. And then usually it's just playtime. And if it's nice again, that's usually when we go outside and play. We have a playground and stuff in our backyard that the kids have a lot of fun on. And then 5:15 is daycare pickup. Some kids are picked up earlier, so that's kind of nice when that happens. So, but 5:15 is when all the daycare kids are gone for the day. And Rick doesn't get home till about between 6:30 and 6:45. So I have a little over an hour to do anything I need to do and make supper. And sometimes I can like put supper in the oven and we can walk the 2 blocks to the park. Or sometimes I already have like supper ready to go in my oven. Like I'll have our supper ready to go. Like I'll make like homemade chicken nuggets and stick them in my fridge, so, and then we'll like go to the library, so then all I have to do is come home at like 6:20 and pop them in the oven and they'll be done, and that gives me like an hour to be gone. So I try and, that's usually when I run my errands. Like if I need to run to the grocery store for bread, that's usually as soon as daycare is done is when I go get bread. But it's hard to, because I still need to have supper done about 6:30, so it's kind of tricky sometimes. Our evenings go so fast. So then we eat supper about 6:45 was when we eat supper. And then it's usually about 7:15 when we're done. If it's nice out, sometimes we'll go to the park or we'll go for a walk. Zane's been really into riding his bike the last couple months, so we've been doing a lot of that. Or sometimes we'll just hang out in the backyard, or if it's not so nice out, we just kind of hang out in the house and play. And my fiancé, Rick, is at... he's a carpenter, so he works outside. So he a lot of times just wants to be inside in the evenings because he's already been outside for like 10 hours that day. So, but we just kind of hang out and have family time unless it's a bath night. I don't have a super strict bath schedule for my kids. I just try and make sure they bathe 2 or 3 times a week. I honestly don't really like bath time that much. And Zane has been kind of getting bored of bath time, so I was actually thinking for Christmas, one of the things I want to get him is a bunch of more new bath toys, so I think I'm going to do that. So then usually around 8 is when I try and be heading upstairs to bed, and I love our bedtime. Brielle's been getting really crazy lately. Like, she wants to be on the bed, but she's like bouncing all over the place, trying to grab the book, pulling Zane's hair. Well, it's been getting crazy, but I love to read as many books as I can to the kids at night. So Zane usually gets 3 or 4, sometimes 5 good books in for the night before bedtime. Then I tuck him in and lights out. And usually then it's anywhere between 8:30 and 9. And usually Rick and I, we usually have some sort of show going on Netflix. Right now it's House, so that's what we watch. And that's when Brielle gets really crazy hyper. She like has a burst of energy after Zane goes to bed, and it's like her mommy and daddy time, and we just kind of play with her and watch our show. And then as soon as that's done, Rick goes to bed since he gets up so early, and she usually goes to sleep anywhere between 9 and 10. And then that's our night, and sometimes I end up going to bed with Rick, and sometimes I end up staying up to clean the house or get projects done or get video editing done or something. So that's pretty much how our week goes. On our weekends, it's kind of whatever, because we have a lot of stuff going on the weekends. We go visit family, we have events going on. So that is our current schedule here in September 2014. Thanks for watching. Have a good day.